Okay, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining this live show, today's live show, Monday, November 16, 2018. We are absolutely very sorry. We can't explain what's been going on with our lines. In fact, we have been changing from one of the other accounts to another, and yet we have seen that there is some serious interference with our connection, with our line. And this has been quite very serious. I'm just going to do this real quick. And we are happy that at least we have the show back on. While you join, you bring everybody on board so that we can share very crucial things affecting our revolution, affecting our movement. And we want to continuously inform our other compatriots that irrespective of the olive branch that has been extended, we must stay focused and fight the enemy, not to stay on the habitual stance of continuously trying to attack other compatriots or comrades of the revolution. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining. All of you joining from Los Angeles, like Nelson Ochemba, you're welcome to the show. Mawe Ekembe, watching from the UK, you're welcome to the show. Mark Barita, who is watching from Belgium, welcome to the show. Kemita Ashu, or Kemi Ashu, watching from London as well, you're welcome to the show. Joshua, Yannick Sikod, everybody who's watching at this moment, God bless you, thank you. Once you join, let's share extensively, and we'll start this show effectively in the next 2 minutes, where we will bring on board some very serious things that would, of course, be mind-blowing and will foster and prosper our movement. We thank you all very much for your consistency, for your commitment, and for the belief and conviction in the independence movement of Southern Cameroon. We continuously want to thank and pray for all ground forces who have stood the test of time trying to defend homeland. We also want to thank all the civilian population who is actually doing the best to ensure that they keep the momentum and to continuously, despite the massacre and the contagious genocide that has been perpetrated on their family members by the regime of Mr. Paul Biya being Vondo of La République du Cameroun. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Ambazonians, God bless you once more for joining the show. So in 2 minutes, we'll start effectively. Thank you, and keep sharing extensively so that we can get everybody on board. While we wait to get everybody, I will try to fix and bring up a couple of things so that the show should be smooth. We hope to have everything right and good so that we can have this sent to everybody. So please, when you join, you share. And thank you very much, all of you, ladies and gentlemen. We're grateful that you're always there for the Ambazonian people. So today basically is straightforward to the point, and we want to emphasize on a whole lot of things for the Ambazonian people to understand. So once you join, you share, keep sharing. We know it's going to be very difficult with the level of the interception or interference in our broadcast, but we understand that every Southern Cameroonian should by now know that the possibility of things like this to happen is normal. Even though we live in America, we wouldn't explain exactly some of the nitty-gritties of the interference. It could be network, it could be hackers, it could be the regime, it could be whosoever, but we only say one thing. We pray to God to give us the grace to continuously stay persistent and consistent in our endeavors in liberating homeland. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you once more. Let's bring everybody on board. Please, everybody should come on board. Let's see what's going on. We know it's pretty very difficult, and we can understand a whole lot of things happening on Ground Zero and people thinking like, what's really going on? But I want to tell you that there is hope, there is joy at the end of the tunnel. So you have to stay fast and stay committed, and you have to know that only one thing matters, and that is Ambazonia. So once you join, you bring everybody on board, share to your various platforms, WhatsApp, And for those of you who are watching on YouTube at this moment, God bless you, and understand that there is one thing that comes first, and that is the people of Southern Cameroon. At this juncture, ladies and gentlemen, we would, in the next 1 minute or so, listen to a beautiful piece of music while we bring everybody on board, and then we start the show effectively, bearing in mind that the regime of Mr. Paul Biya is one of the most genocidal regimes that has ever existed and that is existing at the moment. We want to also apologize that in case this live broadcast is interrupted or there's an interference, you understand with us, because it has been the case the whole of today. We have come on several times and there's been no way to broadcast for reasons we can't really explain. And so we want to thank everybody who is joining at this very particular time from Southern Cameroon, and to say God bless you, God bless your endeavors, God bless your sacrifices. And today we will also be meeting the new one and only true liberation leader of the people of Southern Cameroon that I am going to be announcing on this show. And I want everybody to understand the reason for that announcement. And so we want to put our hands on deck to get this straight up. So once you join, you share extensively, let's have everybody on board. And so, like I said, in the next couple of seconds, we should listen to this beautiful piece of music before we actually get to the crux of the matter. When I say the one true leader, I am not referring here to Sesekwa Yoktabe Julius. Don't get me confused. You're going to get the leader in the course of this program. And that is that leader. I want to, all of us to put our support behind that leader, because it's a leader that I endorse. It's a leader that will give us the latitude to be free, to have justice. And it's a leader that will let all of us understand the purpose and the focus of this revolution. It's a leader that is not arrogant. It's a leader that has suffered tremendous loss. It's a leader that has been in this revolution for many years. And a leader that is humble, that is polite, a leader that helps everybody. And of course, I want you to meet that new leader in a couple of minutes ahead. I'm going to be saying that just before we get to other issues. But in the meantime, let's listen to this very beautiful music. Of course, like I said, I'm going to play something dedicating it to our compatriot in jail and the refugees across the various camps in Nigeria. And of course, this music, most of you will like it. It's titled Sesekwa Yoktabe Julius, but it doesn't mean the leader I want to talk about is Sesekwa Yok, so don't get me confused. Don't get confused, rather. So let's listen to this beautiful piece. Thank you. You come on, you share extensively. Please, once you join, you share and keep typing. La Republic is using chemical weapons in Southern Cameroon, so we want to get all of those things on the screen. You keep writing. I see a lot of people suggesting who is that leader. There is a new leader in the revolution, a new leader that is going to bring lasting solution in the Ambazonian or Southern Cameroon's independence movement. So I'm going to be naming that leader today, and I'm going to be endorsing that leader, and I want all of us to follow that leader with total commitment. Hello, my friend Sulemona, you're welcome to the show. So we must understand that at this crucial time, we must bring our ingenuity, we must bring our sincerity to put in this movement in order for us to get out. I see people suggesting, a lot of people, you are going to get that leader at the end in the course of this particular program. So when we have at least 500,000 people watching live, we are of course going to release the name of this leader. Don Dinka, I want to say sincerest gratitude to your very wonderful and very appealing work. Don Dinka is the cartoonist of the revolution. I need to meet this guy. I need to really meet this person. It's fantastic to see the things he does. I might be saying he when it's a she, but I have a conviction that I say he. That is not to say that I'm undermining the fact that ladies can do cartoons and stuff like that. Please keep sharing and keep writing. There is genocide in Southern Cameroon. Let's get this on and on and on and on. And of course, we want to thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Today we'll get a new leader, the only true and authentic leader of the people of Southern Cameroon. And of course, you know, that is the spirit we must all adopt as a people. And the leader is a simple leader, is an understanding leader, is a forgiving leader, is a leader that understands the plight of the people, is a leader that harbors all of Southern Cameroonians, is a leader that feels the pain, that hears the machine guns, that understands exactly that this is the path that the people have to take. Is a leader that is void of ego, is void of self centeredness. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you, this one leader is a leader you will never regret when you support. And I want to call all of us to support this particular leader. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so very much. God bless you. And we keep sharing, keep having everybody. We'll come back to the music. I know a lot of people are already enjoying the music like crazy, you know. And I want to say good evening to all of you who are watching from Grand Zero. Good evening to those of you watching from Europe. And a big shout out to everybody who's watching from Asia. Those who, of course, watching from other parts of America. It's a big shout out to you, and I will not forget all those of you watching from the DMV area where this live show is being broadcast. I say a big shout out to you and to appreciate you, all Southern Cameroonians, for your undiluted commitment in ensuring that homeland is indeed liberated. We want to thank everybody who is joining at this moment to let you know that the revolution is at a very crucial stage, and that we must compose ourselves like people who understand that they are fighting a war. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be very sincere with you that we have to move this revolution from the level of, you know, a lot of people who have failed to understand that the prosperity of a land would only come based on their ingenuity in maintaining a selfless position, in maintaining a humble position that would change the movement of the Southern Cameroon's independence war. As a matter of fact, ladies and gentlemen, you can see a lot of people already typing "I'm Bali" because of the genocide that has been perpetrated on our people in Bali. Let me seize the opportunity to thank a friend, a brother, Mark Barita, who has been very firm on his actions lately, ensuring that the people of Ambazonia are put completely on top without any compromise. I want to thank all of you, ladies and gentlemen, to assure you, those of you who are listening to my voice at this time on Grand Zero, to know that there is no way Mr. Biya is going to win this war. As a matter of fact, to tell you that the government or the regime of Mr. Biya has already lost the war. They have resorted to the using of chemical weapons, bombs on civilian, and bombs on civilian population. You have seen the case in point is in Bali. They did the same in Baba too, and in other parts of Southern Cameroon, where they have perpetrated genocide at very high levels, and they're almost going unpunished. But I want to assure you, ladies and gentlemen, that you must remain focused, because this is a liberation war. This is a war that must be fought with technique. This is a war that must be fought with psychology, and we must have the strength to continuously resist the enemy. It's a time when we must tell our compatriots on the face that, hey, you, listen, you have to hold on this. And I want to charge everybody to know that there is a new leader in this revolution, and everybody must follow that leader, from Sisekwa Yoktabe Julius, from everybody who is a Southern Cameroonian. You must line behind that leader, because that is the only true leader that, in my capacity as Eric Tato, I say that it's the only leader that I think the Southern Cameroon's people must follow. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this show once more. Let me be straight to the point. I want to start with the regime of Mr. Paul Biya before I get to announcing our leader. Now, I have read and listened to radio and television reports from the capital and other parts that are still under the regime of Mr. Paul Biya. I have also received from confidential sources a communique from the Minister of Defense, Betty Asomo, and of course some other crazy comments from the Minister of Communication, Issa Chiruma, and that of the defense spokesman of the Republic of Cameroon, Colonel Didier Badger. Now, I want to say this very clearly to the regime of Mr. Paul Biya, and I want everybody who is part of that regime to listen to me very attentively. My name is Eric Tato, and I want to be categorical about the things I want to say today or tonight for those of you who are watching from Grand Zero. I want Mr. Paul Biya and his entire dictatorial blood-sucking regime to understand that the time has passed when they can intimidate some of us. Because for somebody like Eric Tato, I have defined and conquered death. Because I'm sure that someday I will die anyway. And so I am not bothered if Mr. Biya has dispatched his best assassins to the United States to kill me, or probably they are trying to tarnish my image, that of my family and my enterprise, to the international community by consistently accusing me of all the crimes they commit on Ground Zero. When the missionary from the United States, precisely from the city of South Bend in Indiana, was killed, I'm talking about Charles Truman Wesco, was shot, killed at point blank by the Cameroonian soldiers in the town in the northwest or northern zone of Southern Cameroon, known as Bambui. He was rushed to the hospital for first aid at the PMI in Nkwen before finally moved to the regional hospital in Bamenda, where he gave up the ghost and, of course, where he died, where several bullets were removed from his head. He was killed intentionally by the Cameroonian military. But in order for them to, you know, to concretize their sabotage against my person, my activism, they quickly cloned my social media account that till date I have not reacted to it because I didn't see it important. And they made as though I was thanking Ambazonian fighters for killing Charles Truman Wesco. Well, that is a case against themselves. Because as a matter of fact, there are categorical ways in which I do my post. And if you do a clone of my account, you must see the number of people who have liked, you can see the number of comments, and you cannot just take a small sheet of paper from somewhere on Facebook or somewhere on your artwork on your phone, and you write stuff and you clone Eric Tato's account to blame Eric Tato. These acts have continuously gone on and on and on, and just recently, after this show, I'm going to post a communique from the Defense Minister, Betty Asomo, who is citing me as that one Ambazonian secessionist activist who has actually caused the death of Father Cosmas in Kembom. And of course, I want to say this to the Cameroonian government, that it has come to a point where I have to give an ultimatum, I have to give an understanding order to Mr. Pobia to understand that I am an international, I'm a journalist of international repute. And I will not have a country that is buried in genocidal tendencies, a country that slaughters people, uses chemical weapons on civilian population, a country whose military or soldiers shoot and kill at birth humans and children below 2. I will not have that country try to tarnish my image. As a matter of fact, I will not longer henceforth tolerate the regime of Mr. Pobia. I've had that as concrete evidences to say that the regime is doing everything to implicate me. As I have been informed, they have sent a communique to major embassies within Cameroon or Yaoundé to try to ensure that they increase their diplomatic offensives to get Eric Tato deported back to the maximum prison in Konangi. However, I am on this note, as Eric Tato, founder, publisher, editor-in-chief of National Telegraph, who is based in the DMV area of the United States of America, I want to sound this clear, and I'm copying by this video the FBI of the Federal Bureau of Investigation and other institutions in the United States of America to understand the plight of the Southern Cameroon's people, and to also tell Mr. Biya that I am giving his regime 10 days to do a corrigendum and take back that statement on my person. I want to urge the defense minister and the other stakeholders in the crimes against humanity in Cameroon and in Southern Cameroon to ensure that they immediately take back, they do a corrigendum, and trying to accept their position of killing the priest. As you are all aware, ladies and gentlemen, you have seen very brilliant outings from the Bishop of Manfe, which documents and, of course, audio recordings we have received, where it has been categorically stated that the regime of Mr. Paul Biya, the soldiers shot and killed the priest, and they also killed another old man in Nkokonye, a quarter in Kembom. The priest was killed right in front of the church, as we reported on National Telegraph, based on the deontology of our profession. You have also heard and you've seen a communique from the Foreign Affairs Ministry of the Republic of Kenya, of course, through the High Commission in Abuja, Nigeria, where they have stated categorically that the Cameroonian military killed their priest in Kembom. We would be not exactly amazed by the very flagrant, useless, and very uncultured lies-telling attitude of the regime of Mr. Paul Biya to have single-handedly, without any measure, any strength of respect and credibility, to pick on an activist who is fighting for the liberation of our people. We have seen them, they have done that severally, and lately they now think that there is one activist that they must pull down by some of their nefarious acts, writing communiques and trying to attach me to it. However, I am today giving Mr. Paul Biya and his regime 10 days to actually fix that, else I'm going to take actions that I will not explain on social media. I want to assure you, the people of Ambazonia, of Southern Cameroon, like we now prefer to call it for diplomatic reasons, that I want you to stay fast and to understand that the regime of Mr. Paul Biya can never and will never defeat Ambazonia. And this fact must be made clear to everybody who is on ground zero, to understand the strength you have, and for you to know that the government of Mr. Paul Biya has only one option left, and that one option is to surrender. Now, let me say this, and to all Southern Cameroonians who are acting in their various capacities and their rights as leaders and activists, that this is a time for us to call for Mr. Biya to put down his weapons, because he can't win the war against Southern Cameroons. I want to tell Mr. Biya, Mr. President, you have to surrender now. Now is the time for you to surrender, because it is going to be really bad and rough on you. And Southern Cameroonians, all of you in your various villages, wherever you're listening to my voice at this moment, you have to put up the stiffest resistance like you've never put it on before. Let me let you know one thing. Mr. Paul Biya will never kill the people he called Ambazonian fighters. And I just want to let you know that if you are with a regime, for people who are pushing federation and whatever, you cannot stay with a regime that has condescended to going to houses, breaking people's doors, destroying their properties, shooting their loved ones at point blank. Ladies and gentlemen, there is no fight against the Ambazonian people or the Southern Cameroon's soldiers. There is simply a policy of killing civilians in order to weaken the spirit of Ambazonians or Southern Cameroonians. May I now say categorically that Mr. Paul Biya must surrender, because in the days ahead, a lot of things are going to happen. And for those who are very tight on the fence, not understanding that this is war, I want you to know one thing, listen to my voice at this moment. We are not afraid. I will not say it when we're going to do it, but let us also let Mr. Biya know that he has crossed the line, and we are not afraid to take this war to Yaoundé. We are not afraid to take this war to Douala. We are not afraid to take this war to Bafoussa. We are not afraid to take this war to Betwa, to Ngandere, to Eborova. We are not afraid. We have the means. We have the capacity. But Southern Cameroonians are dignified people who are standing their ground and trying to ensure that they respect international conventions. But should Mr. Biya continuously try to kill our people with chemical weapons, burn our houses, our villages, rape our women and shoot our children, we let the international community know that at this moment that they're staying quiet, we will not be afraid to take this war to Yaoundé. This one should be a point. For now, we are holding our grounds and looking, hoping some more that the international community will come to the aid of an armless, defenseless people who are only trying to live their lives in peace and in their own country. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Ambazonia, remain resilient. And let me remind you that the time has come. For some of us, we have given our lives and we are not afraid to fight and fight till we die. I move around the United States, no bodyguard, nobody looking after me, but I have the conviction that God Almighty is our guide, is our protector, and we are going to win this fight, come rain, come shine. We will never, ever federate with people who have killed more than 10,000 of our people. We cannot federate with a regime that goes to the villages and burn down the goods and chattels of the peasants. We will never, ever federate with the same regime that is killing children with chemical weapons. Regime that puts bombs on dead bodies. Regime that burns corpses. Regime that has destroyed our socio-economic and political landscape. We will never ever get to do with this regime. Nothing more, because the time has come for us to understand that Mr. Paul Biya has crossed the red line. And that is game over for the regime. I can assure you, ladies and gentlemen, as small as I am, I don't have no mandate to talk to you. I don't have no job to talk to you. It's a privilege. But I want to assure you, listening to my voice from any part of the world, all Southern Cameroonians, from Ground Zero, from Ground One, from Europe, Asia, the Americans, from just anywhere, that do not get worried. You will see more corpses, but that country will be liberated because you can't go back. You are in the middle of the water and you must fight till you cross that water, because the distance you have covered so far is further than going back. And so the time is now for us to concentrate, to understand that it is now or never, and we must continuously put our efforts together as a team to fight the dictatorial regime of Mr. Paul Biya, who probably thinks that he's doing something by trying to discourage our people as a result of killing civilians just every day, every time, anyhow. But let me say something. A time will come when we will take down thousands of La Republic citizens across the Mongo when we ever decide. And we want the international community not to cry foul. Yesterday, I was on phone with some journalists. I was on phone with some officials of Amnesty International. And I asked them one question. Why is it that when 11 students were reportedly kidnapped, the world was reporting it, and when 30 or more people have been burned, and the allegations of the use of chemical weapons and bombs, and the regime, or probably those international organizations, stay quiet? They could not answer. Let me now add my voice to that of Secretary Chris Anu to let you know that if the United Nations cannot protect us, we don't need them in Ambazonia, we don't need them in Southern Cameroon. I add my voice to ask you to uproot anything that belongs to anybody that is conniving with the regime to kill your people. It is your right in time of war. And let no social media troll come to object facts that are pure, that when you're fighting a war, you must look for those very crooked and crucial, cunic enemies supporting a genocidal regime. Now, I will come back to this issue, but let me now pin on very important points. This goes to our defense forces. Whether you are fake or real, whether you fight for the people of Ambazonia, or you're simply out there to do business with our movement, to do business with the war of our independence, let me send this message to you. Stop now or get destroyed. Any person, whether you're in the diaspora or on Ground Zero, that has converted our God-ordained revolution, whether you're sponsored by Paul Atanganji or you're an Ambazonia who is exploiting the desperation of the people to go about kidnapping people, to go about doing things that are contrary to the purpose of this revolution, you have to stop. I say you have to stop because there's going to be no more space for you. I urge all those of you around Keke, those of you around Wututu, Tole, wherever you are, if you are involved in taking people for ransom, you are not fighting for Southern Cameroons. No Southern Cameroonian who is fighting for the liberation of his people can go about kidnapping the same people. So I urge all of us to stay out of this particular mumbo jumbo. This is rubbish that must be stopped, and that must stop now. So I urge you, fighters on Ground Zero, listen to my voice at this moment. Go now if you are involved with the kidnapping of the priests around Monyenge. I use my voice and tell you, he must be released now. That is a fact. We will not go the way the Republic is going, because we know that most often the Republic has been behind some of these kidnappings, but we cannot refuse, as a matter of fact, that both sides are also involved in some excesses. So I use my voice to ask and immediately call for the release of the priests or the priests that were kidnapped around Munyenge, because you cannot fight God. And that is why the Republic has not been able to win this war. You have to desist from kidnapping relatives of those who are in the diaspora to demand for ransom. You have to desist from kidnapping poor people. You have to desist from beating up people who are going to the farms to look for food. Everybody must respect those towns. This war is not a war against Ambazonians. I said it before and have not changed my principle. I'm one activist that has condemned in entirety the kidnapping of our people, the beating of our people, but I have stayed firm on the kind of punishment that must be dished out to betrayers and to those who go contrary to the rules of the revolution. It is a fact that we will not at any moment tolerate issues like this. I urge you at this moment, holding the priest, to immediately release the priest, the priest that were kidnapped, back to their families. I go as well to those who are holding the van and properties of the Banso Baptist Hospital. I urge you to also release that to that hospital. It's important for us to fight this war with our pure hands and to work as a team and to fight and force justice. I want to be very brief on this live show today. I want to now officially present to you the new leader of the Ambazonian people. It will interest you that some people all of a sudden think that because Eric Tato has apologized, it is a right for them to walk around and make declarations, pronouncements, as though they run things for the Ambazonian people. No. You see, I want to repeat and to stay firm on the fact that I love you all as brothers, but we will not tolerate people who are high-handed in their declarations, in their pronouncements, simply because they have social media space. Let me be clear with you, and let me be very clear with everybody who is listening to me at this point. Very clear with everybody. Very clear with everybody. Let me be clear. What I want to say is something that I want you to take your heart to take it. Now, for those who don't know, I want to urge all people, everybody, all the activists who consider themselves as fighting for the Ambazonian people, that if you don't know, there's a new leader that I want to put in your head. That leader of the Ambazonian people of Southern Cameroon is not Sister Kayo Kabe Julius. It's not. That leader is not Honorable Weber. That leader is not Akwanga. It's not Bo Herbert. It's not Ayaba Cho. It's not Dr. Sako. There is one leader for the Ambazonian people that all Ambazonians must know. That leader is Southern Cameroon. It's that country. That is the only true liberation leader of the people of Southern Cameroon. Why do I say so? It looks literal and quite kind of like satiric. But I want to tell you, behold, that there is only one leader. And that leader is Southern Cameroon. All of us, Eric Tato, Mark Barita, Kemi Ashu, everybody, Ayaba Cho Lucas, Sako Ekomi, Sisikwayo Kabe Julius, Bo Herbert, Akwanga, all of you who have social media spaces and who sit out there, you think you can talk anything to the people, I want you to know one thing. Nobody mandated us to talk on behalf of the people. Nobody has mandated anybody to be a leader for the Ambazonian people. You be a leader based on the privileges that the Ambazonian people have given you. And so when you want to talk to a people that didn't vote you to any position, you must talk with respect. The Ambazonian people must come first. And that is why every leader must compromise their egos, their high-handedness, and come down to the table for liberation talks. For us to discuss how we can unite, and not for you to take as a right. I am a lion. I am a lion, and I want to say that. Do not take my apology for granted. I want to assure you that so long as I live in this revolution, for those of you who got scared about my apology, don't be misguided, don't be confused, because we stay focused on fighting La Republic, and we would ensure, just like Mark Barita has said, that Ambazonia must be put first, above the ego of any leader, above the ego of any self-proclaimed leader. This is the time, whether you are Sekchi Chris Anu, Ocho Ayaba, Otapang Ayaba, or Mark Barita, or Kemi Ashu, or Joshua Carr, Atanga Achiri, whosoever you are, put your egos down and work as a team. Enough is enough. This is not a video game, and it will never be. They will not continuously kill people, and we have people who are behaving like poly police and cartoons on social media, who think that because people look at them, gauge at them from a distance, they probably think that they have the opportunity to continuously destroy our revolution. Now, let me say this to all of you, and there's bad news for you. We have to call on all the people who say they are leaders to condemn in entirety what the other social media people are doing. For example, Dr. Ekomi Saku must come out. If you see somebody talking against Cho Ayaba in your favor, tell that person that I didn't mandate you to do that, and tell that person to stay quiet. That is what must happen. All the frontline leaders, self-proclaimed, They must come out and ask people to say, stop calling my name, stop using my name to insult Dr. Sako. Dr. Sako, you must come out and come and say, you, Eric Kato, stop using my name to insult Komecho Ayaba. You, Joshua Carr, stop using the IG to insult AGC. You, Matt Barita, stop using X to insult D. That is how all the leaders must come out to put Ambazonia first. Until that is done, then we'll be ready to move ahead. I want to assure you that I will not have any more time to debate about what policy is good and whether county by county or block by block is bad or which one is good. I don't care no more about that. I have set the agenda for reconciliation and I want to stay on that path, because when we want to continuously make a defense, I am selling CCC Savon. It's the best I know, and I've sold it to the people. Those who are buying it, they are buying it. I will not continuously come and call the name of Savon May. Oh, Savon May is bad. Savon May is this. That has passed. The only true leader for the Ambazonian people is Ambazonia, is Southern Cameroon. It is not you who is talking on social media. Because, of course, you don't know the pains of the people on Ground Zero. You don't know the pains of those who hear all those machine guns. Your house has never been burned down. But you have a phone, probably a free $60 US $60 kind of mobile data or something, and you think you can stand from any corner and shout and write garbage and for the people to get confused. Enough is enough. I ask you to come out from that roller coaster of stupidity, move out from that very infamous attitude of trying to ensure that you disrupt the revolution. There is no more space for people who have failed to understand that we are fighting war. You talk things on social media that don't look like you. You talk things that do not resemble the Ambazonian people. We must strive for the best, because Ambazonia must be first. And I want to assure you that I don't recognize nobody as a leader in this movement. I recognize only those leaders who put Ambazonia first. I am given a challenge and I'm waiting for a leader who will say, okay, I've called Komecho Ayaba. I'm saying, I will, let's talk. Since this issue of reconciliation, have you seen any leader trying to call another person? All of them, they are up there in their houses, saying they are the boss. Boss over who? That's the question. Who made them boss? That is a big question. You must calm down your high horses. Whether it's Cho Ayaba, Dr. Sako, why is Dr. Cho Ayaba, Dr. Sako or Akwanga? You people must stop this rubbish and prevent all these people who have now become like very funny creatures on social media, writing trash here and there. I want to tell you one thing. If I see any bad thing against the IG from an activist, I know that is Dr. Cho Ayaba who has asked them to write. If I see any bad thing from the IG against AGC in support of the IG, I know it's Dr. Sako that has asked them to write. If not so, come out and tell them that, listen, nobody should write anything against Cho Ayaba supporting the IG. Nobody should write anything against. That is what it's going to do. So you will not assume that if Tapang and the rest, they are writing something against the IG, you want to tell me that no, Cho Ayaba knows nothing about it. He knows. He knows, and he simply don't say, he doesn't say those things, and he simply allows the people he has put as his vanguard to go and be writing rubbish and causing confusion while we're trying to solve a problem in this revolution. You cannot say that if, for example, Joshua Carr is writing something against the IG or against AGC, and you say that Dr. Sako is quiet. No, Dr. Sako would know. So it would take the might and the wisdom of these leaders to come on Facebook and say, now, you, stop, don't talk about me, write your news, and don't call Cho Ayaba's name, don't call Sako's name, don't call this person's name, until we do that. If not, I want to say that, just a minute. If not, I want to say that all these leaders, they know what they are doing. And it seems to me that this war is beneficial to them and don't want it to end anytime soon. That is why they have left some few social media gangsters to ensure that they continually put division in the movement. Enough is enough. And this is the time for us to ensure that we condemn in entirety. Mark Barata is doing it. Joshua Carr, you are doing it. Every single Southern Cameroonian should do it. Now, you have the biggest job to do. I've seen in some WhatsApp group that started removing people who are posting bad things. I take my time. They have killed people in Munya. They have killed people with bombs in Bali. There is enough to write. Why is it that you only go and take videos? Okay, General Nambe has done an audio. An activist will take that audio. You put that audio on your wall. saying that it is this man who is also killing people. What are you telling the international community? You take an audio that is referring to us as though we are fighting ourselves and that they are threats. You put it on your wall. On your wall, and you say you are fighting for this revolution. No, you are not. You are the devil. You are worse than Paul Biya. You are encouraging Grand Zero fighters. We have stopped the use. Just excuse me. Let me clean this really fast, please. Thank you. Thank you so much. So we have stopped all the fighters. Everybody on Grand Zero. I've told them, don't send me no videos. You can show me videos. Let me see them and try to plead your case with people who can help you. If I go to Mezam County, I say, okay, this is from Mezam. Like, this video should not go out. I can show them on my phone. Nobody takes it. But you will not run at every little thing when they are killing people instead to concentrate on how you can put out the bad news about our republic killing our people. You are there. You are playing some dirty, cynical, and smelling politics on social media. It's a big shame to you. And let me let you know that your days are numbered if you don't move away from that kind of attitude, because we don't have time for people who think that this revolution is about them. I still want to tell all of you Ambazonians, all of you on social media, that you must listen very attentively. My apology is meant for us to pull on. And I'm not afraid of no leader, no activist. And that should go deep in your head. But I still want to tell you I love you and we should work as a team. That is a fact and that is where we stay. You cannot take a message, a video, audio. In fact, who even put that video, that audio, into a video form to put on Facebook? They are activists. You ask a general to make an audio. They send you a normal audio from Grand Zero. You take it. You take your time. You take a software, you mount a divisive audio, you put pictures and put them on social media, start sharing them. Who are you fighting for? There is one leader in this revolution, that is Ambazonia, that is Southern Cameroon. Put that in your heads. There is no, listen, let me tell you. Otherwise, if there's no one leader, I will say, okay, now in Cameroon, Paul Biya's regime wants Eric Tato's head the most. It's a fact. Whether it's the Minister of Defense, Budget, Communication, basically everybody. There's one man that they want so badly. That is Eric Tato. I cannot be proud of that. It's not a good thing that the regime is wanting me. My business is everything is stagnant. It's not a pride, but I'm putting the people first. There are people, 90% of them, who make noise on social media. The government does not care about them because they don't say nothing that affects the regime. Paul Biya does not care. There are people that Paul Biya don't even know if they exist. But you see them on social media. They're only known by Amazonian people. You never see them anywhere wanted. Never. You never see them on any official document. Never. But I hear that they're stepping the revolution because they know if it fails, they can still go to Cameroon. But those of us who are here, who have put our lives on the line, we are finished. We are done. So, Ambazonian people, listen very attentively. Those are the regime, and those are the regime supporters. Those are people who are worse than the military that kill our people on Grand Zero. You cannot claim that, listen, there is a principle of higher good. If there is some truth that you will say, if you want to assume that it's even the truth that you're saying, if there's some truth that you will say, that would destroy revolution, keep it. My whole time that I've stood for this revolution, talking hard against compatriots or for compatriots, it was because there were issues of money that was involved. Apart from that, I've never taken an audio or video put out there deliberately trying to discredit the AGC or do this to favor the IG. I have taken my time. Look at the video. When General Arike came out, I didn't put it on my wall. He was playing draft. It was not useful to me. A lot of those videos are there that we cannot continuously do that. There are people in this revolution that must be called to order. And I challenge you, Dr. Sako, Dr. Cho Ayaba, Dr. Akwanga is already doing it, calling them to order. Let us call our supporters, our groupies and surrogates. Tell them to stop now, that enough is enough. They cannot be killing people. And you have only people who are out there trying to fan division, hate. And I want to tell you that there is no space for them. There is no space for them and there will never be any space for them. So enough is enough, and they must understand that the lives of 10 million people matter, not the lives of some social media funny kind of people who don't know their left from their right, who don't have a single zinc, a roof in their villages, who don't know anything about, they don't have any square kilometer of land, they don't have any relatives that have been affected, they don't have any property that has been destroyed, any business that has been shut down, but are they are disturbing everywhere and posting on various social media groups, very hate, derogatory speeches against people who have dedicated themselves to lead this revolution. I don't have time anymore what Dr. Troy Aba does, but I have time to correct the things that he says that are not right, that can be detrimental to the revolution. What Dr. Sako does is not my business. I don't work for none of these guys. I don't work for none of the organizations. I'm Eric Tato, independent on this platform. And we must stay focused to deliver Ambazonia or Southern Cameroon to the 10 million people. That should be the message. So we have had enough of these people thinking that they can destroy the revolution. So, Comrade Cho Ayaba, Dr. Cho Ayaba, Dr. Sako, you people should come out and tell your people to stop. Anything that they write, we know who are the AGC people. I see them. If you write anything, it means Dr. Cho Ayaba is supporting it. That is a fact. They sound like the IG people. That's why I've told my brothers and friends that you must stop the hate speech. You must stop. Don't stay on social media. You behave like a caricature. You know, you think that because you have some social media and some 200 people watch you in your life, and you have some 10 likes or 20 likes, oh, you have arrived. No, you have not arrived. You have not gone nowhere. You have not gone nowhere. The time when the Cameroon government will start writing your name on official communiques, start calling your name on radio, that you have done this and sending your name to embassies, that is when you will understand how it is to fight a war. Those of you who go out there on social media because you have space and some useless space, you think you can destroy this revolution. Enough is enough. I've not said that you should not unite, but take your time. Don't think that because I apologize, you have to come and take this revolution for granted. There is no more space for this kind of people. For those of you who are watching me, you're watching me in your thousands. Listen, go to your WhatsApp. Kemi Ashu, take this campaign, put it there. Write, number one, that I've given Cameroon government 10 days to do a corrigendum against my person. Number two, write that I'm advising all Southern Cameroonians in the various WhatsApp groups that if anybody post anything that is not news, that is not talking against the Republic, anybody post that Sako has done this, IG has done that, whether it's Eric Tato, if it is not a constructive criticism that will bring change and brought and their proposals, remove that person from your WhatsApp contacts. Remove that person immediately. You see, the Republic is busy. CRTV is saying things that will kill the poor ground, like, oh, they have thrown our case out of the British law court. It means that we are one and indivisible, which is a lie. It's a big lie. But they are sure they are fixing their own cases. Instead for activists to take time to listen to this and counteract with audios, help their people to change, put their people on the right mind. They are there, they are busy looking at what IG is not doing, what AGC has done. Take for example. You see what happened in Bali. I want to tell us something. In Bali, the AGC or ADF claimed responsibility that there were the people who turned down the military vehicle in Bali, which was not true. It wasn't true. That's a good example. Okay, now, days after, they have come, they have killed people in Bali. They kill people in Bali. Then Comrade Cho Ayaba, with due respect, comes on his live show and tries to blame county by county. If it was the ADF that was in charge in Bali, so they have killed by the block, so it's block by block, that's not working. So I want us to know one thing. If you claim responsibility in Bali, then afterwards, they go and kill people in Bali. You don't talk about it. You are blaming by the structure that is helping people to contribute money. That's not how we're supposed to work in this revolution. And that fact should be clear to all of us. You all saw it on their walls. They were claiming responsibility, being happy that they are the people who did what in Bali. The next day, the military went to Bali and killed people with gas. Instead of them to come and see how we can work as a team, they come, they start moving away, forgetting that they claim responsibility when nothing ever happened in Bali. They claim responsibility from some pictures that came from places that I don't understand. And then they go and kill those same children in Bali. Then they quickly run to go and blame county by county. That is not how we operate. I want to say very clearly that Comrade Cho Ayaba, I respect you. I respect all of you as leaders or self-proclaimed leaders in this revolution. Just as you will say about the IG, that nobody voted the IG. Nobody also voted you. If Dr. Sako is trying to say he's president, and he should also know that the agency people don't recognize that. And the only way for us to work is to come as a team. That's how we're supposed to come as a team. Because when the ADF is claiming responsibilities in places, and the military goes there and kills people in those places, the ADF should take responsibility of those deaths and not blaming a project that the people have embraced. That is how we're supposed to do it. And I want all of us to know that we are brothers. And I respect all of you. So when you go claim responsibility in this place, in Boyo, in Bui, in that, when the Buban house is there, take the responsibility too. Don't blame block by block. Don't blame county by county. So until we learn to calm down from our high horses, to know that this is not the time to be saying that who is good, who is bad, who is that, we will not go nowhere. We will not. So I want to just use this live video to do this very clear illustration to tell Kometo Ayaba, Dr. Sako, Chris Anu, and every Ambassador that if you come out to do a live show, talk more against the Republic and talk about unity. Don't talk about which policy is good, which policy is not good. Don't talk as though you are the Alpha and Omega of the revolution, as though you, the Ambazonian people, owe you any price. No, nobody owes nobody. Everybody is here because you choose to be here. Every character is here. After this live show, I can drive my car, go to somewhere, go to a McDonald's. But there are people in Munya who will not go out. After a live show, Tapanabo will go to his work. You see, the other day he was on a live show saying that he's hearing because he has to go to work. So who's going to work on Ground Zero? I go to work. They don't go to work. You do your things. You touch your wives. You do everything you can, and they are there. Somebody, take for example, in Bafut today. In Bafut, one old man saw the military coming. They came with many ammo cars. On going back into his house, they shot and killed him in front of his door. That is how bad it is. The same thing has happened in Mutengen, where a 14-year-old child was shot and killed. Just the same thing that happened in Munya is happening everywhere. And you cannot come on social media and you come and start fighting which policy is good, which one is not good. The time has passed, my brothers and sisters. We cannot continuously try to fight each other. Let's concentrate on our Republic of Cameroon. That is what is important. It is not some social media talk left, right, center. You don't address the people that are suffering and you don't go down to them, let them know they are suffering. They can kill people, burn some alive, and you come on social media and you're using the corpses of our compatriots, of our fallen heroes, and you're making political social media gains on them. It's not going to work that way, because this is a situation that we find ourselves inside. If you want to trace who should be blamed in all this stuff and this and that, we shouldn't be saying that it was because this man went to this place or this man went here. We should be staying on one voice, that there's only one person that is to blame in this revolution about the death is Mr. Paul Biya, who declared war on us, not coming to fight Dr. Sako or coming to fight Kometo Ayaba. We're going to fight Komakwanga, or say blah 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 is good. Those who don't know guerrilla warfare, they should stay quiet. Who? What do you know? Where did you study that? Is guerrilla warfare not something anybody can read in the books and come and talk about it? No, let's be serious. If going county by county, does it stop somebody from doing guerrilla warfare? The people you claim responsibility in Bali, and the next day they kill 30 something people. You refuse to take that responsibility because they are dead bodies, and you use that same dead bodies that you are claiming responsibility to be blaming the people. It's not going to work that way. We have to move out from that cocoon of docility, that roller coaster of stupidity and that refusal to be honest. We have the capacity, the propensity to be honest as a people, and we cannot continuously stay on the line. So this one should be a message to every leader, irrespective of who you are, whether you're the interim government, you're the IG or whosoever, come out from your high horses. Move out, and think about the people who are being killed on a daily basis. They cannot be killing people and you're doing politics. Let's be honest. All the leaders who sit here, they don't contribute no money to no group. They live basically on the contributions that you make. And so they should be humble enough to come together and talk as a team and push this thing ahead. So we should be honest. Of all the activists that we have seen, clear demonstration, there are only two who contribute their money. Myself and Mark Barita. Mark Barita does his book, pays, he contributes. I've asked him to send books for me to sell in the US because he's doing a great job. So we should know that. No, let this, from all of them, let them show us what they have contributed. Let them show us. You want to fly to come to America, or you want to, okay, Dr. Choi is coming to America, so Paul must pay his flight. Dr. Sako wants to go to Florida. He's not paying from his pocket. People are paying his flight. They same like Chris Anu. They go, you come on meetings, you sleep in hotels. You do everything that is good for you, and the people are suffering. And you don't have the humility to come and say, oh, let's talk. Listen, I'm not for any government or for anybody, but I support the fact that the interim government is existing as an institution. And this should be a fact that people should know. And when they say that people should come together, Mark has proposed that they should restructure the interim government, which I'm endorsing. It's important, bring everybody on board. So why are you people not talking to yourselves? Is it that you have so much money coming out of this struggle that you are stealing, and you think that nobody should come in contact with that money? That's the question I want to ask you. So all the leaders, this is a chance for you. We are already winning this fight. So come together, put your acts together, and let's win once and for all. Let me be clear. I will not tolerate everybody who is anybody who is insulting people on this world. Please, let us try to be constructive. So the only way out is unity. So any leader who thinks that you are so high-handed, you cannot cooperate, we saw it yesterday. There was cooperation yesterday. Sergio Chris Anu, when I saw the flyer of Sergio Chris Anu, I immediately called Mark Barita. I said, Mark, bro, see, how can Sergio Chris Anu, except that he doesn't know, he knows that Komechoya, but he's coming here, and I shared that stuff on my wall. He's coming at this time at 9. Why will he put his own show at 8:30? He will not be finished by 9. So I'm sure that they got to him and he changed it, because we have to be as a team. So all these leaders, you have a small privilege to have assistance from the contribution, because you are doing something. For me, I don't need it from nobody. I have never and will never take money in the name of this struggle. Never. 2 days ago, one of my friends here in DM called me, and I went to his place. I met two of my supporters, or my fans. They came all the way from Texas. And when we spoke, they gave me something in my palms. I opened it, was $50. I was like, no, take it back, listen, give it to your accountant. And they forced me. I took that gift because I saw a genuine person. I've had one of our mothers who came from Cameroon. He brought me an African wear, these Bamenda dresses. She's watching me right now. She's seeing me watching because I see her, I know her profile. And we took pictures together. After, oh, keep it. When independence will come, you're going to show that. 2 days ago, it was just yesterday, you know, some other our brother from the BLM, he came to my house after my reconciliation with Tapan, and then he called me. I went to that yesterday. He gave me, for Thanksgiving, a brand new laptop from the BLM. I feel so happy. And I said, oh, thank you. This is a gift. Listen, people will give you things that you don't imagine. And I've told people that I don't receive no money from nobody. People should understand that if you want to be a leader, you must think about the people you want to lead. You must think about the people you want to coordinate. In fact, call yourself a coordinator. Don't call yourself a leader. Don't even bother about saying you're a leader or you're a ruler. Say you're a coordinator. Let me tell you, we can go far as a team. So please, all the leaders, know that you live on the benevolence of the people. And if you want this movement to finish as fast as possible, forget, except that you are really gaining a lot. Because I don't know why we cannot cooperate. I don't know why. I've said it, and I'm going to say it before. A time will come when most of them will not have space. And for all those of you on Ground Zero, give some of us time. Give some of us time. Give some of us just some little time. We're trying to observe what these leaders are doing. They say the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violence taketh it by force. A time will come when I will step up and I'll tell you something that nobody will believe. Trust me. I give them, there's enough time for every leader to cooperate. When we say live, we say things on live shows that are constructive. You have some people whose jobs, you don't see them watching with their profiles. You will never see them. But as soon as we are finished, they know everything we have said. Those are the creators of the disunity. The ones with fake profiles. And they ensure that you see one person will do a post. Then there are 10 or 15 comments like you see in some of their posts these days. And it's the same person who is changing profile, saying the same thing in different ways, making small grammatic errors because they want to be authentic. Do not look at them. Do not look at those things alike. A time will come when people will be on their live shows causing division, and God will strike them dead. That is a fact. And that is my prayer for those who do not want to see a reason to unite, to cooperate, to stop writing garbage on social media in the name for the sake of the Ambazonian people. We have 10 million people. And to tell you the truth, most of us on social media, we are broke people. The most of all the people that you see, they don't have any money to spend. Those who spend their money are in the background. You know what? Somebody like Kemi Ashu, whose face is not put out there. You know what the job she does? You don't know. There are people who have thousands of dollars who put in this fight every day. There are people who spend $1,000, $2,000 every month or every week. There are people who put a lot of your money. You think because you have social media, you come and stay for 3 hours, you tracking here, left, right, talking nonsense. You don't have nothing. If you have anything, I've challenged all the activists that let's look for a fund for activists or something. Let's put money there. So, okay, one activist, come and put $5,000 or $10,000. Give it to the Ambazonian people before you come back to talk on social media. None of them will talk again. All of them will disappear. There should be a fund for all leaders. Let them come. Say this is what they do. This is the money they want to put there. Let's do this. So if this doesn't want to unite, they don't want to cooperate, they have a problem. So all of this, we should learn to understand that the richest people who put their money in this movement, they are behind the scenes. And somebody cannot be investing in something that they are not seeing the direction that's going, because they are reading you on social media and you are giving them sleepless nights by the writings you, by the things you write. I have only one conclusion. I don't want to be proud about the things I've done and what I want to do and the things I'm doing. But anybody who has not seen any reason to unite, that person is an agent of the Republic. Either knowingly or unknowingly, that person is an agent. If you have seen no reason to unite, you are a problem. If you truly think that it's Ambazonia that you are fighting for, you are a problem. So let us be sincere. You cannot say, like somebody come and say, oh, we want a liberation war and stuff like that. Then you go, you are still calling somebody president. Or you are still saying this or that and that. We don't have time for those things. We don't have time. I've told people that, see, if you see some activists who are pushing that AGC must not unite with the IG, it's because probably Dr. Choyaba is giving them small money. They have small money that they are taking. Those who are pushing that IG should not unite, it's because when IG unite, they'll not be having that money again. But for somebody like me, I don't need your money. No, it's the truth. I don't want to brag, but there's no way. The little that I have, I manage because I'm thinking more about the people. So what is your interest if those people unite? What is going to stop? That's the big question. Because you are there every day, you are writing up and down. I don't know if you are really writing on behalf of the AGC or on behalf of the IG, because the things that some of you write, we don't understand. I still do not understand. So what is your gain? What do you gain? That you are writing very divisive things on social media. Every 2 minutes you are there, you don't work. Every 2 minutes you are there, the news is happening in Mutengene, in Munya, they are killing people. You don't post that. You are only there, these are the things that we must do. The AGC should have done this. The IG is not doing this. This one, I mean, excuse me. You have people in London, like Emmanuel Ekeme, who are putting their time and their money there. They advise you. Dr. Makongo is there, he's going to place, he's spending money. And you people are here, I still want to challenge Dr. Sako and the rest, that you people should come out firm. I have people in the IG who have sworn that they will never unite. There are people in the AGC who also think that they will not unite. It will not work. We'll break those bonds in Jesus' name. Because you don't run Southern Cameroons. You don't run. The IG must be restructured. Remove people who are redundant. Propose to the Akwangas and the Ayabas. Let them refuse in public. Let's see that they have refused. That is the point. Propose to them. Let them refuse. Let's say they have refused. Go and, initiate talks. The IG is saying that they are a government. So you are a government, you are afraid to go and negotiate with people. If you are a government, why are you afraid? Yes, it's our IG. Why are you afraid? We know when Seseko was here, he met all of these leaders. All of them, they came here. Some came here and they did foolish things, but Seseko continued. So this is the time for all of us to put our hands on deck. Let's try, let it fail. Then we know that, okay, now some other thing will come up. Well, I have things that will say, more things like the Sokare, the Southern Cameroon's Rehabilitation Fund that I said last time, and I want to call this one, I want to call the name. My friend Tapang, when I was writing that they don't do rehabilitation in time of war, and Tapang is saying that they should channel money to Aya Foundation. Now, there is this, our Nigerian sister, Abdullah, who has raised some money for refugees. Can you also ask her to channel her money to Aya Foundation? No, Tapang, you're my brother. You don't do that. Like Mark has told you, you don't just write, you don't just think that because you have social media. I'm talking to you directly as a friend and brother. I'm talking to you one-on-one now. I want to appeal to you again for the last time. You're my brother. And I want you to know that I love you. And that's why I'm trying to assist you to be constructive. You said it on the live show and everybody heard. We cannot be fighting each other, Tapang. If I bring a proposal, you have my number, why didn't you call me to see how I can augment it? Must you go on social media, you're writing? You know how many things just surely that I've screenshot and sent to your inbox? I'm trying to tell you this because you wrote that in public. We are not, you see, when we say Southern Cameroon's Rehabilitation Fund, you know, the issue is just that each time you write against a policy from seeker of truth, it destroys you almost instantly. How can somebody of Tapan's capacity say that there is no rehabilitation fund during war? It's wrong. In everything, we have pre and post. There is a prehabilitation and there is post. You must bring together money. So if you don't rehabilitate during war, what is the definition of rehabilitation? You can rehabilitate people, structures, and all of those. Even a small technique should even tell you that the Republic is, if rehabilitation during war was a bad thing, China will not be giving $1.8 billion, CF or whatever, to La Republic for rehabilitation when the war is still going on. So, my brother Tapan, you are supposed to be a scholar. And I've said that I will not insult you. I'll only advise you. And I'll let you know that you are my brother. Calm down. I beg you, brother. Calm down. Move. Fight the war. Not only take your hand now for the right. Now for the right, 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 right. You know, because as some person just talking, money the one spoil revolution because people only think about money. I have proposed a fund. Like I proposed county by county. Joshua Kai is there. I have never in my I have never taken $1 from somebody. People will call me. Everybody is watching me. When you call me, I'll say, no, this is Joshua Kai's number. This is a person for Fako. This is a person for Meme. I don't take no money because I will never. It is not my place. I'm not interested. So if there is a project and that rehabilitation fund was proposed, I proposed it to Walters Kayaka, who caused you and I, Tapang, to reconcile. And Walters Kayaka is from AGC, a big AGC member before you came. Those that people put their money in the AGC. So I want to only ask my brother Tapang that I know you have contributed your time and your effort in this thing. If you come and you're writing all this divisive thing, would you mind to understand that the people matter? I'm asking you. I appeal, I love you, my brother. I'm still saying it in front of all these people that if I've done you anything that is so bad, forgive me, let's move on. Don't only see you go and cause division writing things. It's not good, bro. Calm down. If you accept my apology is political like you wrote, forgive me, bro. I'm still begging you that we need to put our forces together. Look at how Mark and I were cooperating. You come together. Let's fight for the people. Let's not fight for a group. What are you doing with spokesman of ADF? Is it better than the Ambazonian people? Comrade Cho Ayaba, like I've said, and Dr. Sako, we must calm down. We must calm down to ensure that all these people who are writing trying to defend us and defend ideologies that are not proper, let us denounce them. So I still beg all of you. I know after this live show, some of you will carry antennas like this. But remember one thing, let love lead. I'm not insulting any of you. I've only said that we should work as a team because that is the only option. That is the only option. If you have anything that you want to suggest to a compatriot, to anybody, come to the person. Call the person. I've written to you several, you don't respond. I don't know why. So come say, oh, brother Tato, this thing that you said like this, don't you see that if you do it like this? So that when we are going to the public, we will come with a force, you know? We'll come with a force that is so powerful so that they will not see that we are fighting. It's not important. I'm your brother. I came to apologize to you. And I apologize with my heart. And if you think that you still hold me in your heart, call me and tell me that, bro, this thing, if there's something that you said that I've said that you did not do, ask me, I'll come and do a corrigendum. If that's the thing that will solve the problem, that will cause us to unite, I will do anything. If you want me to sleep on the street of New York or wherever for you to work on me, tell me, I'll come sleep. Because it is disheartening that they are killing people and then we are only doing politics. Somebody says this, the next minute Ivo is there, you are saying some other thing. Until Mark got angry and had to reply for the first time. We have to come together, Tapan. We have to come together, bro. I beg you in the name of God. I beg. You have a wife. If your wife is listening to me, let her touch your heart. Before, I was also very rowdy. Let me put it that way. And it was not helping a revolution. And like my wife, like other people have advised me, and I thought that it is good to listen to people. So I'm appealing to all of you. Let's forgive everybody. Let's move on. Because see, the number of people that they have killed, it is a factor to weaken our egos. Except you are the devil, the kind of things we write. If you see the people that they have killed, you are supposed to come and say, no, I cannot continue this fight with Tato. I can only focus on the Republic. The other day you call Mark Barita will be crying. And you ask yourself that why? All these our brothers, you are activists, you have platforms. Look at the way you can channel your energy. Look at Solomon Amambu. He's doing a fantastic job, even when he's in the enemy's den. Look at the Kembe Emmanuel. I've told Joshua Carr. I've told Nelson Ochemba. I've had people who have called me that, listen, don't do this. I said, listen, bro, let's do this thing. Leave it. I've called all my friends. I called Della the other day, said, bro, this post that you have put up is not good. Take it down. Della immediately took it down. You know, I called Kuku the Blink, say, sister, this thing I wrote about Bali, it looks somehow controversial. Can you just take it? She said she'll edit it. She goes there, she edits it immediately because we want to pacify the atmosphere. Please, I pray that we all talk to our brothers, talk to our followers. Let us understand one thing, that people have died enough. Thank you very much. I don't want to continue this show. I feel very emotional now. And thank you. I think I should end here. I think I should end here. Thank you so much. And God bless you. Keep praying for us. And remember that every Ambazonia must put Ambazonia first, Southern Cameroon first. That is the one and true leader of this country. So once more, I love all of you. Kemi Ashu, Mark Barita, Yannick Sikot, Joshua Carr, Tangan Chui, Kuku Da Blins, Bella Franklin, Capo Daniel, Lucas Asu, Tapan Ivo, Mami Gera, Vivian, Waters Kiyaka, everybody, Amambo Solomon, Kembe Manuel, Kemi Ashu, Ashu Kingsley, all of you. I love you all. And from the depth of my heart, I seize this opportunity again and tell all of you that if I've ever hurt any of you, I'm sorry. Let's put our acts together and work as a team. I'm sorry, and that is the only thing I can say now. But nobody should anyway take this for granted. God bless you, and long live British Southern Cameroons. Long live all of British Southern Cameroonians, and short live the movement. Thank you. Bye-bye.